All right, guys. Well, welcome back to the podcast. Today, we're joined with Raphael from Zapiti. Raphael, introduce yourself.
Yes. Thank you, Shane. I'm very happy to be here with you to talk about the Zapiti products. And I'm looking forward to answer any question you may have or your audience. And yes, it will be cool. Yes.
All right, so let's discuss the Zapiti 4K NAS backup machine. I know you guys don't want to call it ripping; we're calling it backup for various reasons.
Yeah, because ripping sounds illegal. We prefer the term backup because it's really what it does. You just back up your collection like you want to do with your pictures or your personal videos. And we try to make it easy for you to do that. Of course, there are some ways. You can always back up movies with your PC, but you have to be aware of the process. It can be painful, and so we wanted to address our customers and to make the process of backing up very easy for them. And I guess we succeed because I know that the our customers are quite happy with the NAS.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And the drive is pretty quiet and it rips movies rather quickly. Could you discuss how quick it is to, say, rip a 100 gig 4K disc?
Yeah, it could take up to 1 hour to do that. But most of the movies are, for UHD, the normal average length is about 40 minutes. I guess so. It can be even quicker. Some movies can be ripped up to 25 minutes. Mm-hmm. So it depends of the capacity and what's on the disk. But our drives inside is very reliable, and it can handle every capacity, every disk. You can put it in, and it will rip automatically. And you just have to wait for the tray to open. And then that the backup is complete, and you can enjoy it with one of your Zapiti players all around your house.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty simple.
And it's a NAS drive, so you can add up to 128 terabytes, right?
Yes, if you choose to go up to 16 terabytes, which is not the maximum, but the best drives for the NAS are 16 terabytes maximum for now, which is pretty good already. And yes, you can start with 3x16 terabytes at first, because as we are using a RAID 5, it will be mandatory to have at least 3 disks. But you can expand all with your needs. If you have a big collection, we will advise you to go with the 8 base directly. So you won't miss any data, because the expansion on any NAS can always be tricky. So we really advise you to just do one expansion. So you can start with 3, but if you want to expand, we would advise you to go to the full stack of your drives. Okay, it's the less you expand, the better with the security of your files you will have.
And now, when you pop a disk in to get ripped, where does it go? How does it fill up each drive?
It's a volume, for people who knows how RAID 5 works. In fact, your movies goes quite a bit everywhere on your drives. If you have 3, your movies will be splattered everywhere on the 3 disc. That's why we call it a volume. So basically, your movie will not be on a specific disc. It will be on the volume. So the volume is composed of at least 3 discs. And so you can't extract the movies from a special disc. You have to extract the movie from the volume, from the folders, in fact.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And if you Once you rip a movie onto any of the drives, can you copy them over to another player? And how would you go about doing that?
Yeah. Yes, of course. You won't have any protection anymore. That's the process of backing up your disk. So yes, you will be happy. You will be. It will be possible for you to copy on another hard drive. You know, inside another ZPT player, for instance. It will be very easy to do that. In fact, you will access your NAS like a regular, you know, NAS, or it will be like a normal computer. You will go to the video folders of your NAS, and then you will copy and paste the movies that you want, that you need, to another location over your network. So it will be it will just take less time for you if you have a gigabyte network to do that, because obviously the UHD files are quite greedy on your bandwidth. So, but I guess, you know, for UHD it can take less than 10 minutes to copy from the NAS to any other hard drives located in your network.
And you would access that through your PC?
Yes, of course, or your Mac. Or you can even, you know, you can copy and paste from the ZPT to your PC or to another player over the network. But if you do that with the ZPT player, for instance, it would take much more time than if you do that from a computer, whether it's a Mac or a PC.
Right. And you
so
mentioned...
I strongly advise to use a computer to do this kind of backup.
You mentioned that it runs on Windows, right? The Ripper, the backup machine.
Yeah. It's a Windows server. It's quite reliable for us, and we can install every application that we have been working on for the last years. In fact, it's way better for us, and we can have access. You know, and we can monitor the health of the NAS of each customers, and it's very easy with the Windows OS inside of it's easy for us to do that remotely, of course.
And I see on the site here you can do four disks simultaneously.
Yes, you've got, of course, an internal drive that is provided when you buy a ZPT NAS, but you can add three other external drives, which are exactly the same model as the internal one, but we made a special case, you know, and you can plug it with a USB 3, and you can add three external, and so that you can do four, you can back up 4x4, and it will take much less time to do to complete your collection.
So you mean three extra Rippers?
Three extra, yes.
Okay.
And one internal. That means four total. Okay. So you can rip. You can back up four discs at one. At each time, you know, and it won't take much more time, you know. They will do, you know, you don't have extra times when you rip 4x4, for instance. You know, it will only take 25 to 30 to 45 minutes for each drive. You know, you won't add any much time, you know, when you rip multiple drives at the same time.
And since this is a PC,
yeah,
what do these I haven't messed around with this yet, but what are these extra, you know, the HDMI out, the VGA, DVI, does that have any functionality?
It's only for service only. It's just for us. You know, if everything is goes wrong, you know, with one of your units, we will use that and in our office to check what is going on. With it, so you don't have to know to plug it into your display. Mm-hmm. You just have to plug the power cord and the Ethernet cable. That's all. Okay, just a storage device. Okay, it's not a device that you can play some content directly on the TV. You will need one of our players to do that.
Okay, so you can't. So there's no GUI if I plug my HDMI into this or anything
no,
like
no.
that.
You will see a Windows message telling you that you can have access to this device. That's all.
So the other USB, can I hook up an external drive to these?
Yes, you could, but you know, to prevent any loss of data or any viruses, we didn't enable the possibility of backup directly from an external USB directly into the NAS. Okay, because we have already the case as trying to back up one of his hard drive, and there were some viruses inside this unit, mm-hmm. and the NAS went completely crazy. So we didn't allow it anymore. So if you want to copy from one external disk that you may have, you just plug it into your PC or your Mac, and you copy and paste directly into the NAS. Okay, it's for safety reasons.
Right.
Okay, and if you want more storage, you can just, you know, add another hard drives into your units, but you don't need external USB drives to do that.
Hmm.
But again, you can also mix, you know, you can have the majority of your collection inside your NAS, but you can, you know, add a movie folder from an external drive that you can plug directly into one of your players. Okay, so you can mix your source of videos, you know, from the NAS, from your computer, from the internal drive of any Zapiti player you may have at your home, and from any external drive that would be plugged directly into the players, mm-hmm. if you want to do that.
That's interesting. And you know, we were talking about earlier, since there's no GUI or anything like that, I was thinking that there wouldn't be much to show, because basically all you do, you pop your disk in and you wait till the drawer pops right back open.
Yeah. I know it's disappointing, but that's what we wanted to be. No, we wanted it to, you know, for people to not, you know, care to read anything about the product, because a NAS can be quite complicated. You know, believe me, I know. I've got a NAS since 20 years, you know, and it can be very difficult to learn and understand. And we wanted this product to be available and to be used by everyone around the world. So that's the way we wanted it to be. But I know for the geeks, you know, it can be very disappointing, but that's the way we wanted it to be.
Yeah, just to let you guys know, basically all you do is hit the open button on the tray, you pop your disk in, you wait about 20 to 40 minutes, and you wait for the disk to open, and your movie's automatically on the drive, so you don't have to do anything. And then it rips it into an ISO format. Correct on that?
Yeah,
it's an ISO.
Always, because it's the only way to keep, for you to keep, you know, the menu, the extras, and all the image and audio quality present on the disk. So it was very important. I know that, you know, some of you who are listening to us are using some MKV. You know, you can, you know, copy and paste MKV directly into the NAS, but we want it for our users, you know, to have the best quality possible. And the ISO disk is perfect for that. You know, we will keep everything, you know, Dolby Vision, DTSX, everything, and all the extras, of course. And since, you know, for 2 years, we are able to have most of the Blu-ray menu and the UHD menu, it's quite cool to navigate and see some extras from time to time.
Mm-hmm. And of course, these are bit for bit copies, so they're the exact replica of the movie or CD that you're doing.
And believe me, it's very important. I've got quite a good collection of my own. You know, I've got almost 2,000 Blu-rays and more than 400 UHDs. And I've, you know, when I start backing up my movies, I noticed by there were some problems with, you know, brand new disc that I had for, you know, for several years, I didn't open. Mm-hmm. And when I tried to, you know, to back up or to play it, you know, I couldn't do it because there was a problem with the, you know, the wax on the disc, and it was, you know, it was broken. So if I made the backup before, I could have kept the disc. So it's very important to tell our audience that, you know, every physical disk, you know, are not, you know, a lifetime guarantee. So when you back up your movies, when you buy it, you will be sure to keep it in your original quality.